Anshula Kapoor, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for inviting me and for having me here.
Anshula, congratulations first for everything that you're doing with your online charity platform, Fankind. Please tell us more about this venture, how it works, and what made you foray into it.
Fankind is primarily a fundraising platform, fankind.org, with the main purpose of helping fans have their dreams fulfilled by interacting with or meeting or owning something that's been created by or worn by their favorite celebrities. So we've done, we started pre-COVID, so we used to do in-person experiences and we started primarily with Bollywood. With COVID, we pivoted into doing virtual experiences where we had multiple fans meet their celebrities, interact with them and do activities on video conferencing. And then we also pivoted into conducting auctions. So currently on the platform, our second auction is live and open for bidding, where Royal Challengers Bangalore was very kind enough to donate the specially created blue jerseys to us. Each of the jerseys have been autographed by the cricketers themselves, and they are being auctioned on our platform to raise money to conduct mobile vaccination drives in semi-urban areas with the help of Give India to be able to vaccinate more of our country so that we can all come out of COVID as fast as we possibly can. The money that is the donation as amount of it directly goes into the bank account of Give India, and you receive a tax exemption ATG certificate for it. So it is as cut and dry as possible. You are directly donating to a charity's bank account so that the money can be used for the vaccination drive. We've done virtual experiences in the past where out of everyone who's donated, we've had 5 or 10 winners be able to get a chance to interact with their favorite celebrities. For example, play a game of Antakshari with Vicky Kaushal, things like that. It is a platform where you can just come and take a look at the experiences that are live and donate to your heart's content for your chance to be able to fulfill your dreams.
That's very cool. I have many questions about this initiative, but I'm very curious to know how it all started. What made you foray into it?
It started because I come from a family of actors and filmmakers. My brother is an actor, and in his initial days of being an actor, he wasn't on social media for the first 2 years of his career. So I was on social media, and I didn't really realize that I need to make my account private, because I didn't realize that anyone would find out who I am or even reach out to me. But people did, his admirers, his well-wishers did. And that's how the ball got rolling for me, where it used to give me great joy to be recognized as his sister. Or if someone reached out to me asking me for an autographed CD, because this is back in 2012, 2013, where CDs were still a thing and DVDs were still a thing. So people would reach out saying, can we please get an autographed DVD for Isha Grade, for example, or for Two States, for example. And it would give me great pleasure to be able to send it to them. So for me, the whole idea of fans being able to interact with their celebrities sort of started from what I was doing in my own house with my own brother. And I just realized that if people are reaching out to me to be able to get to own even a small part of him through autograph memorabilia, then maybe there is a larger world out there, and maybe I can do this for more than just my family or my brother, and maybe I can do this on a larger scale. So that's one aspect of Fankind, and that's where that came from. And the fact that we crowdfund and fundraise for various charities and NGOs comes from something that was very close to my mother's heart. I grew up in a way where she was almost adamant to a great extent about the fact that padhai likhai ke alawa bhi kuch aur karna hai. So even when I was in school, it was not like school work kiya, homework kiya, khelne gaye, bus. Like, that was not life. It was always about, if we come from a place where we are able to give back in any way, even if it is through our time in the community that we live in, how are we helping out? So whether that was through teaching like after school in Urdu medium schools or Hindi medium schools, helping the kids there with their math homework or with their English homework, small things like that, is something that started out from her. So it's obviously when you're doing something right from the age of 10, 11, it sort of becomes part of your life. And it stayed with me. And when I was thinking of Fankind, before we even came up with the name Fankind, it was very clear to me that I want to be able to pay my respects to my mom and carry this legacy of her forward. And the only way that I could think of doing that was to include a major aspect of her teaching in my life onto what I'm doing, which was, how are you giving back to the people who are in your universe, are in your periphery, and you could help them in some way. So that's how two very important people in my life sort of gave me the inspiration, and it was like a culmination of both of their learnings and or both of my learnings from them that came together to create this platform.
You know, this actually shows what a noble heart you have. You actually thought of such an innovative way to help those who are in need in these cynical times. You have actually tied up with 16 NGOs across India who will be distributing free vaccines for the poor from the funds, of course, collected by these auctions.
For the auction, for our platform, we have we've tied up with Give India. They are our philanthropy partner. For every experience that we have ever ran so far, including the current auction that is live, Give India has always been our philanthropy partner. They've always been the NGO to which the funds go, and they help us navigate the world of which NGO needs the funds right now, what is the micro campaign that we're creating, how is it that the funds are actually being used on ground. So yes, we have helped 16 NGOs in the past year and a half of our existence. At present, the auction is raising funds to be able to conduct mobile vaccination drives through one of Give India's partners, Narayan Health. We're raising funds for mobile vaccination drives for semi-urban and urban areas. But Narayan Health and Give India in this realm do a lot more than just conducting the vaccination drives. They help with capacity building. They help with they work with local government bodies, etc., to make sure that the vaccination drives can happen at larger scales. They work towards education to sort of eradicate vaccination hesitancy or the misinformation that is around. So there's a lot that Give India does with Narayan Health. And in our particular case, with the funds that the auction is raising, Narayan Health is going to be procuring actual doses of vaccines that will be administered to the less fortunate who aren't able to buy a vaccine. And they come from areas where the free vaccination centers that the government has been running so beautifully across the country is not available to them within their community.
But is it only, the focus is only on the corona vaccination, or are there going to be more areas where you'd like to help those who are in need?
Currently, the focus is on COVID-19 vaccines. But in the past year, we've run campaigns where we've helped with providing ration kits and hot meals to daily wage workers. We've even helped with fundraising for children who are battling cancer. We've done two virtual experiences where we fundraised for Carol Foundation, for example, to help provide nutritional needs for the children who were still going through their cancer treatments while the country was in lockdown. So we've helped with providing cash in hand for migrant workers during the first lockdown last year. So in our capacity, we have done as much as we could with the help of Give India over various causes. But each campaign focuses on one particular cause. And right now we're focusing on providing as many mobile vaccination drives as we possibly can.
So apart from Arjun, who are the other family members of yours who came forward and backed you in this venture?
My family is extremely supportive, whether it is my cousins, my uncles, my dad, my aunt. Everyone has been extremely supportive. If when it comes to bouncing ideas, I have my cousins I can pick up the phone with. Before we had an office, we were using one of my cousin's office spaces. He was very kind enough to be like, you can use my conference room as your base. So like the whole family has been very supportive, and they've always been there for me whenever I've needed any kind of assistance in that sense. In terms of actually doing celebrity experiences, we've done an experience with Arjun, and we've done an experience with Janvi. I'm hoping to be able to do experiences with Anil Chashu and Sonam Devi and everyone else as and when we can possibly roll those out as well. but they've more than just being on the platform as celebrities, they've been there as family members, constantly approachable and reachable, and I truly appreciate that.
You know, I recently saw this post on Instagram where one of the winner of Fankind contest played paintball with Varun Dhawan. According to you, which has been your most satisfying experience so far?
Before COVID, we actually were doing in-person experiences. So we've done multiple in-person experiences with Varun Dhawan, with Sonakshi Sinha, Alia Bhatt, Karan Johar, Karthik Aaryan. Each of them were extremely special. Varun, yes, the paintball was the first experience we launched with. Varun Dhawan was the first celebrity I approached to do an experience on Fankind, and he was very gracious and very kind to say yes. So we launched with him, and because it was the first experience we were fulfilling, I was extremely nervous. So that experience will always hold a special place in my heart, but it's like asking a parent to choose their favorite child. Like, I can't just pick one. I have had equal amount of fun when we baked a cake with Alia and Pooja Dhingra. I've had as much fun when we've been in an arcade with Sonakshi Sinha and the fans, and we've played arcade games. I've, like, every experience for me, I was like, wo bachcha hota chocolate ki dukaan mein, matlab yahan dekhu, wahan dekhu, kahan dekhu, itni excitement. I was that person. So my team members sometimes tell me that you actually make experiences that make you happy, because looking at you when the fan is interacting with a celebrity, it feels like your dream is being fulfilled. But we're hoping to be able to go back to doing these kind of in-person experiences soon, once COVID is no longer a threat.
You know, it would be really interesting to see all these fan meet video as a series on YouTube. And what would be really cool to see your chachu Anil Kapoor meeting a fan?
We have a small capsule, I think a 7 or 8 minute capsule of Varun Dhawan's paintball experience with a fan on our YouTube channel. But yes, we all of the other in-person experiences that we hosted, we have, we did record those on camera. So maybe soon you will see them on a video platform where you will be able to experience it yourself as well. Coming to having Anil Chachu on Fankind, that is my dream. In fact, I was telling him this week that I'm going to come to you and we have to do something together. So, and he the large-hearted man that he is, obviously has said, whenever we will do this. So I am actually very excited, because I call him an energy ka volcano. So I want to have that volcano explode on Fankind's platform as well.
Is there a list of your favorite star you want, who hasn't so far hasn't come and did this fan meet, and you want them to?
My list is endless, but the whole point is that we have we actually have a feature on the website where fans can come and tell us who they want experiences with, and then that's how we try and get those celebrities on board and try and get those wishes to come true. So more than my dream list, it's the dream list of our users who come and tell us who they want to interact with. And it's, yes, predominantly a lot of the dream lists are with people from the film industry. But that was before we launched with other verticals. For example, now that we have launched with cricket, and that also happened because we had a lot of people writing in to us saying that we want to do an experience with Virat Kohli, or with MS Dhoni, or with Rahul Dravid, etc. So we had a lot of people coming up to us saying that we want to interact with cricketers, which is what made us diversify into this field. So as and when we get users writing into us saying we want to meet Celebrity X, I am more than happy to go to Celebrity X and have them try and come on board. God willing, that will also result in my dream list coming true.
Let's talk about something very cool, which everybody struggles these days, but I think you have mastered that thing, which is this writing this cool captions on Insta posts. And what a cool one-liners you have. I just want to read out some. This weather truly tests my willpower. You wrote for a plate of bread pakoras. And then another one is, you are too tall for your head to fit in. And my favorite is, why does it look like a floating head? How do you come up with these cool one-liners, these Insta captions?
Thank you, you're very kind. Most of my Instagram captions actually are very, it's me, whatever comes to my mind, I put it out, or like if the image speaks to me in a particular way, if I see something funny in a particular photo, I'll highlight that. It's about, I don't actually put in too much thought into my captions. It's just inherently what I'm feeling or who I am just comes out in those captions. I love food. And so I think the caption that you were talking about where it's basically me with like on a table, there are a lot of like there's bread pakora, there's samosa, there's like chaat, there's like a bunch of things going on. So, and the photo was posted in the monsoons when all you want to do is eat pakora and fried food while it's raining outside. So it was very natural. It's more of what I'm feeling in that moment. I put it out as a caption.
Anshula Kapoor, thank you so much and all the best.
Thank you.